Okay, so before starting to weld, you have to make sure you have your PPE on. So that's your jacket and your gloves over here and your helmet. Once you have all these with you, you can keep the helmet and the gloves aside until you turn everything on and then put those on. First thing I like to do is put the ground wire, connect that to the table that you're going to weld to. And essentially without this here, you can't really weld because there won't be a complete circuit that kind of does the welding, passes the electricity, melts the metal, and then does the welding. So once that's on, second step is to turn the main switch on over here, and then the machine switch on. You're gonna hear that beep, and that's when you know things are good. And then you move on to the gas flow. First thing to do is turn this on, and remember it's counterclockwise on, clockwise off. So we're gonna go counter until you see this move up. That means there's gas flowing through. And then I'm gonna tell you how to check how much gas is flowing through this tube over here. But first, we got to go down here, unravel the gun, and then come here, and then this is the feed rate, or the speed at which the wire comes out. And we have to dial this down, all the way down. I like to dial it all the way down, so that when I do a test, I don't want to waste a lot of wire. And then I'm gonna click on this trigger, but I'm going to be looking up here to see how much air goes. And there's a steel ball over here that kind of goes up and down, but depending on how much gas is coming out. And you can see it's kind of up to 20. I want to lower it down a bit to maybe 15, and that's good. And you can see barely any wire came out. When you're ready to use, you have everything set up, you turn away from the table, and then you kind of just amp this up a bit, make sure the wire is coming out, and then you're all set to go.
Power rating?
So then we get into the actual welding. You have to find out what material you are going to weld, and then based on the kind of the material, the thickness of the material, we'll plug all of that stuff into a formula to find out how much power we need, so how much electricity we actually want to flow, and how fast we want the wire to come out of the gun, or the feed rate essentially.